If you want to add a gradient to your text, we're about to show you how all the functionality works right over here.
First, click on the title in the timeline and make sure the playhead is positioned on top of it. Navigate to the inspector on the top right. If the inspector isn't visible, be sure to toggle this icon. Then click on this text icon to make sure the text inspector is active. We'll click on this text box to remove the highlight, so that we can see the epic gradients we're about to create. Now scroll to the bottom of the text inspector window. We'll apply the gradient to the face of the text, so click on the checkbox next to face. And click on Show to reveal the controls. At the moment, the face of the text is filled with solid white. If we click on this drop-down where it says Color, we can change it to Gradient. And we'll expand the gradient controls by clicking on this triangle to the left. Let's scroll down to see every control we can play with.
I hope you're mentally prepared for the awesomeness you're about to experience.
Let's talk about the basics of gradient first. These tags on the left of the bar correspond with the top of the text. Tags on the right of the bar correspond to the bottom of the text. Depending on the tags we apply here, we can affect how the colors blend into each other. There's a lot we can do, so let's jump right in. First, let's take a look at this white bar at the top. This is the opacity bar of the gradient. By default, the opacity of both ends is 100%. We can add another opacity tag by clicking anywhere on the bar and lower the opacity by using the opacity slider. Now the gradient becomes completely transparent at the bottom. And if we move the tag across the bar, it will adjust the position of one end of the gradient. Next, this middle bar gives a preview of the gradient. The checkerboard pattern on the right tells us that this end has a lower opacity compared to the solid color on the left. And this bottom bar controls the colors of the gradient. If you click anywhere on the bar, you can add another color tag. And if you ever want to delete a tag, simply drag it off the bar. Down here, these controls correspond to the type of tag we have selected. For example, if we click on this opacity tag, the color controls are grayed out, and we can adjust the opacity of the entire text object using this slider. If we click on this middle tag, we can use the slider to adjust where the midpoint is located on the gradient. And if we click on one of these color tags, the opacity control will be grayed out, and the color settings will become available. We can click on this color well to change the color of the selected tag. Alternatively, we can adjust the color using these RGB controls. We can think of these as adding or subtracting red, green, or blue from the current color. Also, if we want to duplicate a tag, we can simply hold Option and drag the tag to the right or left. We'll change the colors a bit to make this next example easier to visualize. You may have noticed these controls to the right of the sliders. This top icon reverses the position of the tags, which flips the opacity of the gradient. The viewer may not immediately display the change. Clicking on a tag is a quick way to update the viewer if this happens. And below that, this tag evenly distributes the tags across the gradient. You can do this with colors as well. We can reverse the order of the colors. And with this button, we can distribute the colors evenly. Here's how that looks. The color tags are distributed evenly in the inspector, but as you can see, the gradient looks much different on the text itself.
Colors and gradients give you endless options.
Now let's get into the rest of these controls, but first, another color change. Now we'll explain the three different interpolation settings. A tag set at constant creates a constant color distribution, which means it'll act like a solid color until the next tag. A tag set at continuous will set a range of change between the adjacent tags, which you can adjust using the middle control. And a tag set at linear will create a uniform blend through to the next tag, so it doesn't have a middle control. But you can adjust the sharpness of the transition by moving the tag around. Next, location allows you to move your selected tag with this slider control. Type lets you choose if you want the gradient to be linear or radial. A radial gradient creates a gradient from the center, radiating to the outer edge. As you can see here, each letter is treated as its own gradient. A linear gradient creates a gradient from one point to another. So at the moment, our gradient goes from the top to the bottom of each letter. But we can change that with this angle parameter, which lets us choose any angle from 0 to 360 degrees.
And that's how you control the start point, end point, and everything in between when dealing with gradients in Final Cut Pro.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, and click that little bell notification so you get notified when the latest Final Cut Pro tutorial is up for grabs.